So you can start.
So we have 3 minutes now. It's okay. Am I pronouncing things
Collé.
Collé?
Collé. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It's French, sorry.
Pardon?
Sorry, it's French. It's a bit
it's
hard.
French. Oh, yeah. Okay.
Thanks for coming. I will going to speak about PHP 7, which was released a few months ago. After a small introduction, I will try to enlighten a few internal changes. Of course, I will not speak about all the change, there is too much change, but just to understand why you need to upgrade to PHP 7, what will be the benefit for you. Then the user change, the thing most users of PHP will see will have benefits. Then after the, which is mostly the why part, we go to the how part, I mean when and how PHP 7 will go to Fedora. And of course, some question. So, just for people who don't know me, I am mostly the PHP maintainer for Fedora and Red Hat. And I am also now a PHP developer, which means I work upstream for the PHP project. So, the first slide is about PHP next. So yes, for PHP developer, 5 + 1 = 7. Always a bit strange mathematics for PHP. So the question is, where is PHP 6? In fact, a few years ago, there was a PHP 6 development branch, which was mostly trying to introduce Unicode in PHP, to have Unicode everywhere. But after a few years of development, we decided to kill this branch. It was too bad for our performance and not enough benefit. It don't worth it. So we killed PHP 6, and so we decided to jump to PHP 7 because if you search on internet, you will find articles and books about PHP 6. So to avoid any confusion, we are now go with PHP 7. So what that change internally, probably most of the thing you will never notice because if you use PHP, but it's for developers and to understand some of the benefits. First, the goal of PHP 7 was to fix the gap of performance with HHVM. I don't know if you know HHVM, which is a sort of fork of PHP developed by Facebook for their own need and that people can use. A lot of people think to switch to HHVM because of performance, because it is really faster. So the main goal of PHP 7 was to fix the gap of performance. So PHP 7 now uses a new engine, which is ZN Engine version 3, which introduces really a lot of change. All the internal API have been cleaned up, rewrite, to improve performance and to improve speed. I take one example, which is in old PHP 5, if you look in the code, you will see a lot of pointer to zval. Zval is the main object in PHP. And now with PHP 7, we are going only to use zval, which means the API is totally different. So everything which is built, C extension, is now broken because the API is really a new API. We have also a new memory management, which have been rewritten nearly from scratch, which is mostly inspired from gmalloc. Adapt, it's not really gmalloc, it's something adapt from gmalloc, inspired from gmalloc. So everything which have been done in this, which was called PHP NG during the development phase, we save a lot of memory. All the internal structure have been cleaned up, are smaller, so we allocate less memory, and we also do a lot less allocation, and everything contribute to speed. I took a big change because a lot of people, when they saw about the size T on in 64, things we are going to fix the gap between 32 bytes and 64 bits build. No. So if you see this feature, you must remind this is an only Windows feature, which allow Windows 64 bits to have 64 bits for PHP. So this is really a no change for Linux on overall operating system. Except here, we use, in previous PHP 5, we were using integer for size of all the string and all of the objects. Now we are using sizeT, which make communication with a system library much more simple and much more clean, because we are all talking the same thing. A a few of the other changes I'd like to invite. Before, we have a huge parser, which parses the source code to be able to execute the code. Now with the Zend Engine 3, we have a two-pass parser. On the first pass, produce an abstract syntax tree, and then it is parsed into opcode and executed. This could be very impressive for the future when we are going to try to implement JIT just in time to get more speed. Most users of PHP don't care about this, but developer on the debugger on a lot of static analysis tool, and so we'll take a lot of benefit of this part. I don't know if some of you have already tried to write C extension for PHP. It was quite hard for the trade safe build, because we have to carry the trade ID everywhere in the code in every function call. It was quite hard. So now we have a native trade layer. So it's very, very simpler and quite very simple. You can clean up all the old stuff, which is no more needed. You can keep the old code if you want to have an extension which work with PHP 5 and PHP 7, but all the macros are now empty macro, so you clean up. About what is called expectation. Expectation is, it's when you want to use assert in your PHP code. Assert exists in PHP 5, but are mostly unusable, because when you have insert in your code, even if you are not in debug mode, if you are in production, you have you lose a lot of performance, and PHP become very slow because of assert. Assertion have been rewritten from scratch, but now you can really use assert in your source code, because when you are in production mode, this is a no cost. This is really clean up, remove from the opcode, and really, really no cost for execution. So now assert can be used in PHP 7. Starting with PHP 7. PHP 7 introduced what we call floorable object. I will talk about this a bit later in the user land, but which is mostly what is used for exception in the language. There is a lot of change with exception in the language. As I can talk about all the changes PHP 7. So if you want, you can see this link, which are written all the RFC, which are draft, under discussion, under vote, and implemented in PHP 7 and in all PHP versions. So, what is the result? The result is performance. So here is a small graph from Zend about PHP 5.6 and 7.0. So it is not abstract benchmark. It is a benchmark done on a real application. So you have Zend Framework 1, Zend Framework 2, WordPress, Drupal, SugarCRM, CRM, Magento, MediaWiki, so really real case application, something that everybody uses. And what we can see is globally twice faster. Really a huge performance boost.
Are those page load times?
It's rather the number of pages served per second, but the result is the same. So you can take this as a joke, but of course, if PHP is twice faster, this means you can shut down half of your server. Yes, global warming, probably not the reason why people are going to use a PHP 7, but really, when you only need half of the server you have today, this means you are going to lower the cost of your infrastructure. So this is one of the reasons why a lot of people want to switch as soon as possible to PHP 7 to be able to reduce the cost of running infrastructure. Really a huge, huge benefit. And of course, this also means as the language is much more faster, you are able to do much thing directly in PHP. You have less need for writing C extension, because C extension are, of course, faster, but really hard to maintain. So you can now write for a lot of things. You are now able to use pure PHP library, pure PHP implementation. About, as I said, the internal API have really changed. It's really a new API, which means most of the extension which works for PHP 5 will not work for PHP 7. It's a huge, huge change. So here, a small list. It's not an exhaustive list of all the extension which exist for PHP, but this is the list of the extension which are already available in Fedora. So you see, today, there is around half of the extension which are already ready for PHP 7. But some are really missing. Some are in progress, for example, Imagic or Memcache or Xdebug, which are really big extensions, very, very often used extensions. They are not ready, but close to be released. Some are not ready. We are waiting for Upstream to port the extension. I can try to help some of them. I already port some, but we are waiting. So in the big one, which is missing, we have EJ binary, probably Radius, Xcache, and Xhprof, Twig, etc. So we are waiting for this extension. So something which you have to notice, a few extensions have chosen to release and to use the same version to produce a version which is compatible with both PHP 5 and PHP 7. This is really simpler for user. You use the same version for both. But this means you have a lot of conditional and it's much more complex to maintain. So this is, for example, Xdebug, for example, has the same version which works for PHP 5 and PHP 7. But some other extensions have chosen to have one version for PHP 5 and another new version for PHP 7. So, for example, EPCU version 4 works with PHP 5 and version 5 works with PHP 7. So it can be confusing for users. So because you see a new version, but you can't install it with your old PHP 5. So this is sort of blocker for me. Really, we have around 10 extensions released for PHP 7 in the last week. So really, things go further. We have new version every week, but I'm still waiting for some of them. Just to enlighten one, which is very used, the Mongo extension, is compatible only with PHP 5 and will never be ported to PHP 7. So if you use this extension, you have to change your code to use something else. And something else is the MongoDB extension, which is a bit different, which is really cleaner, and which is already compatible with PHP 5 and 7. So if you have PHP 5 code, you can start to work on moving from Mongo to MongoDB. So, something probably more simple, what change for user of PHP, for people writing application using PHP? First, PHP is not a type of language. So everything you have, a string or an integer or something else, PHP will try to change and to cast and to transform your data. This is by design. PHP was designed 20 years ago, and it was chosen to be a non-typed language. Well, but users asked us, we want a typed language. We could have said, if you want a typed language, don't use PHP, use something else. But, so, first thing, we introduce scalar tip in tip items. So, you can say a function expect an int, which was not possible in PHP 5. PHP 5, you can say, I expect one object or one array, but not about Scala. So now you can say, my function expect an integer. Really something new for in the PHP land. In the same way, you can also, I don't really care of the code sample, but you can also say this function will return an array, which is really new. You can declare about the return type of a function. Totally new, really a big change, but a change requested by our user. And finally, we can say enter the strict tips mode, which means if the function expects an integer and you call it using a float, it will not work. Without this flag, it will work as before. It will convert the float to an integer and the function will work. You can have a warning and something. So now if you want a strict typed language, you can, using this, and for example, I have not the code, but you will have fatal error when you are trying to call a function which expects an integer and you give it a call, float. So really, really a new word for PHP. User asked for it. We've done it. About exception. Exception is something old in PHP, but you have exception, and you also have error. And when you encounter the code encounter a fatal error, a parser error, or something, or now a tip error, the program just dies, and you are not able to catch. This is an error. This is not an exception. So now, with PHP 7, we have, I took already a throwable interface, which is the top level. We have exceptions, which are exactly the same as exception in PHP 5. And we have error, which now are exception, another kind of exception, which can be raised by type error or parser error, but no, you can catch them. It's very, very, very new. This doesn't introduce change and incompatibility. This is very important. So if you have an old PHP 5 code which catch exception, it will continue to work on only catch exception. If you want to write PHP 7 code, you can now catch error, and you will catch, for example, the type error. But there is no behavior change with PHP 5. PHP 5 will still run the same way, which was compatibility was very, very important for a lot of features in PHP 7. So, of course, this is a major version. So, of course, we have break a few things. So, I'd like to enlighten a few things which can break your application. The first, we remove four extensions. Those extensions were deprecated for years. And for years, we are telling people, don't use this anymore. Of course, people are still using this. For example, the MySQL extension is very used because there is tons of examples in documentation on internet about using the MySQL extension. This is deprecated, this is dead, and this is unmaintained in PHP 5. If you have a bug in MySQL, nobody will fix it, even in PHP 5. Nobody cares about this extension, really. So you have to switch to MySQL E or PDO MySQL, which exists for years. But I imagine people are coming. A lot of people are coming and cry, where is my extension? So, EREG is also very old. This one is to access Microsoft SQL Server, but it is mostly maintained. I was a bit sad to see this extension disappear because Windows user have a good extension which is a native Windows SQL Server extension, but for Linux we only have the MySQL extension. So, and we also remove a lot of server API, but probably if you look at the list, this is not something nobody uses this for years. This is all really deprecated things. Of course, Apache is the old Apache 1 extension. We still have support for Apache 2. No problem. So, if you have another application running on PHP 5, you should really look at deprecated message. But I understand on a production machine, we always disable deprecated message, but really for development, we need to fix all the deprecated things with PHP 5, because when you go to PHP 7, deprecated are removed, as it was expected. Another deprecation. This is really about very old thing. This is PHP 4 constructor. Probably if you look some old code, you will see a function with the same name than the class. This is the old constructor way. This is PHP 4, really, 10 years ago, which is totally deprecated. But PHP project, we are probably nice, too nice guy. So we don't remove it. We just deprecate it, make it deprecated. Which means you can continue to use it, but it will be removed in PHP 8. But seriously, for me, this is a criteria for the thing I maintain. For example, I recently removed from a Fedora repository more than 30 packages, which was a peer package. We still use this constructor, And when I saw in an application or in a library that the library worked with PHP 4, I say this one should die. Really, 10 years after PHP 5, it should die. But we still allow it, and it will just write deprecated message in your log. On the other one, it's something which should never exist, but which exists in PHP, which is you can do static call to not static method. This is very strong. If bar is a non-static method, you can call it statically. And we still allow it because the peer library use it a lot. And you, in the first line of the function, you have if is set this, it's a normal call, else it's a static call. So this is very awful, but it exists. It was an old thing from PHP 4 again. So it still works. Another small break. Now, when you use internal classes, and there is an error in the constructor, PHP which raises an exception. Then you can catch. This is really what every people writing our object application expect from an object language. So this is just something that everybody asks us to do. So this we can have change if you try to cast, if you try to have an exception handler or an error handler, as the constructor now raise an exception rather than an error, you have to adapt your code to be able to catch properly the things. So, but it's just something very interesting for people wanting to write nice code, really object code. So, the next one is probably the worst breakage in PHP 7. The examples are a bit complex, but when you have awful things like this, first, if you want such awful thing, you have a problem. You should really want simpler things. But with PHP 5, you can have random interpretation, random understanding. With PHP 7, it's clearly left to right. In all cases. So you have change in the behavior. I say this is the worst change. This is a cleanup. This is something which need to be done at some point. But this is very hard to detect, because you have to run the code to detect there is something broken. It doesn't work the same. Often, it will raise a parser error on an undefined object or something. So if you have unit tests, it's not a problem. You will detect it very quickly. But this is the worst thing, because it's very hard to detect and to fix. The examples are probably a bit complex. So last change, there is some new reserved keyword. Reserved keyword such as boolean integer string, which is now keyword, but you cannot use it anymore. Yes, these breaks some application. I remember a big library which used a class named string, so it doesn't work anymore. But yes, we need reserved keyword. So, just to summarize, which is very important, the compatibility with PHP 5 is very good. Of course, I have tried to enlighten the breakage, but the compatibility is very good. Most of the time, a clean PHP 5 application will work without change on PHP 7. So, Yes, Symfony is already ready and is already compatible with PHP 7. Zen Framework version 2.5 is already compatible. When I say it's compatible, I mean Zen say it is compatible and we support it, which is very important. Because a lot of things work, but upstream that don't support PHP 7 yet. So for this two big piece, it is supported. So in Fedora, when are we going to see PHP 7 in Fedora? A lot of people ask me the question. We are still running 5.6 in Fedora. So how? In Fedora, we have a single stack, a single version of PHP. So the plan is to update PHP to 7.0.3.4, I don't know, to work to ensure everything works. We have a nice tool, which is Cochet, probably worth a talk only about this tool. Probably we'll have to drop and to remove a lot of things which are dead, unmaintained, and which are not compatible. So a big cleanup of the repository. Just the work is already done, just have to happen in Fedora. We can imagine a dual stack, which is just something I don't want to do, so if someone else wants to do it. I have very, very bad experience with PHP and PHP 5.3 in a real file, so I prefer to not do it in Fedora. We can imagine parallel version, having two stacks like Python 2, Python 3, but this is not something which is very interesting in Fedora, because as I said, compatibility is very good. So we don't have to keep two versions during 10 years, like the Python 2, Python 3 things. Really, we have to move from 5 to 7. Oops. And the last thing I'd like to see is software collection, because this is really the best solution and something I'd like to see, but this is just not allowed in Fedora. So, really, we should have PHP 7 since Fedora 22, and we should, when we are going to update to PHP 7, I think we should keep a PHP 5.6 software collection for developers. If we want to provide a full feature distribution for developers, really, really, I think we need software collection in Fedora. So, just a quick demo, if it works. So, I'm just a clone of Composer. Composer, it's a PHP tool very well used, just to show you how it works. So, I'm going to activate the software collection, so we don't care about the system I am running. It can be Fedora 23, can be Real 6 or CentOS 7. I just switch to PHP 5.6 and run the unit test. It should be quite just. So we have 5.6. Oh, is it 5.6? Yeah. So 6 seconds. So now I switch to use PHP 7 and I run the test suite again. And as you see, it's much faster and use less memory. I just switch to the presentation. Time can vary of a runner, but globally we have half of the time and half of the memory. So really, it's worth it. So So just to the last slide, when my plan, if nobody complain, is to use Fedora 24 for a big cleanup to upgrade things we need to be upgraded. For example, I remember OnCloud need to be updated to 8.2, clean up all the old stuff, then introduce PHP 7 in Fedora 25, another project, and probably PHP 7.1 for Fedora 26 or 27. This is the plan. A few links you will be able to find. Just to highlight, there is a Fedora PHP special interest group with a mailing list. You can join if you want. And there is also a CentOS special interest group about software creation. So if you have question. Yeah. Yes, it's still needed. With Offcache, you have something like 10, a factor of 10. So really, yes, you still need it. But now, as the Offcache is part of the PHP itself, it is maintained with the language. We don't have anymore the problem we encountered with the old PC. Which was maintained separately and which was late for PHP 5.4, if I remember correctly. It was late and it was a blocker for a lot of people. Now opcode, opcache is part of PHP, so it's working with PHP 5 and it's working with PHP 7. There is absolutely no problem. So I think you win.
Thank you.
Yeah. Was discussed. There was a proposal. As often in PHP, we have a discussion and we have a vote. And the syntax was improved. It looked a bit like C. So I think everybody will like it. So I think we are out of time. So I think we can talk outside. But I think we have to leave the room. Thanks.
Nice presentation. I liked it a lot. I'm not a PHP fan, but it was an awesome presentation.
Thanks.
May we please have the... Just copy PDF, if possible.
Can I understand how it works? No, PDF. Here,
yes.
The top?
Yes. If the name is descriptive.
The name is DevConf PHP 7. So
yeah, it's pretty really descriptive. Okay, thank you very much.
Okay. Yeah. 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 Yeah